Okay, let's see how we can use this Genesis Code library inside of Blender. I'm using Blender 2.8, the beta version. So let's see. First, delete your default cube, go to File, Import, and FBX. Now select your file and simply hit import. Okay, as you can see, our model has been imported, but it's too small. So what we are going to do, we are going to hit S on the keyboard and scale this up. Okay, so this looks good. Now if you look closely to the cloths of the model, it's pretty rigid, it's pretty hard surface. So to fix this, we are going to the modify section and add a subdivision surface. Now as you can see, you have three things to take care about. The first thing is view, render and quality. I'm going to keep the quality to 3, render to 2 and view to 1. Now view basically means what you're going to see inside of your viewport, how many subdivisions you are going to see, and render basically means how many subdivisions level you're going to see inside of your render. So it's better to keep view as low as possible, since you don't have to actually, if you want to see or take a look at how your model is looking, you can crank this up to 2, maybe 3, but I'm going to keep it to 1 since I know it looks good. That means 2 will be pretty fine in the final render. So select your hand, add a modifier, subdivision surface, and let's do the same with this. So moving on, now let's hit Z on the keyboard and switch to look dev to see what you are dealing with. And as you can see, our model is pretty shiny, a very reflective surface. Obviously the textures are pretty, you can say, wrong. Now to fix this, what we have to do, we have to invert our roughness map to correct this mistake. And first I'm going to change the whole shading to something like this. Okay. And I'm also going to take a plane, hit S, scale this up, and let's add a material. Let's make it black and roughness to 0.2, metallic to 0.9, and specular to 0.2. Okay, let's bring this up. G, Z, yeah. So now let's fix our whole texture scenario. Now let's go to the shading tab, select your model. Okay, let's start with the shoes. So as you can see, our textures have been loaded. We have principal BSDF, diffuse map, specular, roughness, opacity and normal. Okay, so since we are using FBX, FBX formats are preloaded with textures. So all we have to do is hit Shift A and attach an invert node. And that's it. There you go. So do the same with each part. Okay, so everything is done. Let's go back to the layout tab, and this is what our model looks like. So let's go to the rendered view, hit Z and select rendered. And as you can see, our model looks something like this. So first of all, I'm going to go to the world tab and change the whole color to complete black. So we have something like this. And let's go back to the look dev and let me just delete the whole default light. And inside of our background, I'm going to add a texture of environment texture, and I'm going to bring an HDRI. Click on this. Browse your image, and I've loaded my HDRI map. If you don't have any HDRI map, you can simply Google them and download anyone you want. Now as you can see, this is what our model looks like. A few things to keep in mind: when you select your camera, make sure you lock and use local camera, so you'll be able to change your whole look of the camera. Okay, and something like this. Okay, and now let's go to render and render image. So there you go. Enjoy.